So about the IBC lawyer, Kialo Mwaki, already said, so I don't want to tarnish anything he said. And so I want to talk about the dissolution of the parliament. So actually, if you all remember, our youths were being killed, then the parliament were quiet. Then the government blogger, when Gabriel Oguda was abducted, Opio and I almost burnt parliament because his blogger was abducted. That's number one reason for me. So actually, the day we occupied parliament and that guy took the mess was the day we dissolved the parliament. Now that the opposition has joined the government, our country is a very dangerous place since the IMF laws will be passed without any opposition. Actually, they have already been passed. As from today, you've seen about the ukipanda mbegu, kama una license, unalipo 1 million. And the parliament should be dissolved now that they don't have the people's interest at heart. They only have the interest of William Ruto at heart. And William Ruto is controlled by everyone, you know. Imagine you voted for Kimani Ichung'wah only for him to bring the livestock bill that will kill farmers who farm and keep livestock. You will not plant crops without a license and a degree from agriculture. This parliament need to go. You will not plant our ancestors' indigenous seeds. Actually, the parliament has two houses, the Senate and the National Assembly. So the Senate also is not spared. Why? UDS nominated senator called Tabitha Maureen Mutinda brought a bill called Press Control Bill. This bill, Kenyans, this bill will give Ruto powers to set the prices of essential goods like oil, maize flour. And another senator called Senator Hamida, she's on Twitter, Mneza Msalimia, and it was Senator Hamida. This stupid woman, alienda huko akapiga mapicha IMF, hizo mapicha zake ziko online. Kuingia Kenya hivi, alileta bili yenye inasema, ati kama unapanda njugu, oil crops, you need to also have a license. So you guys need to protect your country. Na bado sijaongelelea land bills, seed bills, whatever. Hakuna time, but TB vaccine being tested in Kenya. BCG phase 3 vaccine tested in infants in my county, Siaya. So I always talk about the route of IMF and Bill Gates in my account. So for civic education, you can follow me. And our president is a madman. Saying on Ruto moving around, promising to build university in Nyamira. Yet lecturers and university workers are going to strike on September. So, yeah, thank you. And that's my submission.
Sir, asante sana. G-Flora, before you go, you are next, right? G-Flora 1. I hope I pronounced your name. At Maisha 1G, you'll be the next one. Your mic is hot. I'm coming to you. But I also want to circle back and just refresh the room and just make you guys understand that we are speaking about reconstitution of the IBC. What are the possibilities? Is he going to appoint the commissioners? Is he going to reconstitute IBC so that we get ready for the next? Because that's a tactic. Until now, we don't have a functional IBC. If for example, any by election today, we can't have a by election. If a governor or an MP passes on today, we cannot have a by-election, yeah, because we don't have an IBC. So what does that mean for the country? And what is the process of even reconstituting that IBC? And what is the process of dissolving that parliament? Is he in the capacity to dissolve that parliament? Under what capacity will he dissolve that parliament? Under what circumstances will he dissolve that parliament? Because if in Kenya, the dissolution of the parliament is governed by the Constitution of Kenya, 2010, especially under Article 261 and Article 255. Today, I want us to speak about facts, facts and figures. No stories ajaba, no emotions involved, and we're keeping to the topic. And me, I'll guide you guys. If we have to go the dissolution way, number one, there's automatic dissolution. In Article 261, Section 1, it provides that the parliament is automatically dissolved at the end of its five-year term. Okay? And this means that the National Assembly and the Senate ceases to exist at the end of the term, and general elections must be held to elect new members. We're in 2024. That will only happen under that provision. It will only happen after 2027. Okay. Number two, dissolution before term end. The constitution provides that mechanisms for the dissolution of parliament before the end of its five-year term under specific circumstances, e.g. Article 261, Section 3 provides that the parliament, the president may dissolve the parliament if, number one, Article 261, Section 3A, the National Assembly passes a motion of no confidence against the president. Do we have a National Assembly that is going to pass a motion of no confidence? Under what circumstances is that going to happen? Article 261, Section 3B says if the parliament fails to elect a new president after the office becomes vacant, the office is not yet vacant, and the deputy president is unable to assume office. Mnafikiria ule mtu wetu wa mtu wa Murima anaweza kata kukua president, anaitaka na damu yake yote, o mtu wa Murima anaitaka na damu yake yote. Article 261 Section 3C says if the parliament is unable to if the parliament is unable to enact the necessary legislation for the implementation of the constitution. Where does that lead us to? If we go to the presidential dissolution under Article 261, Section 4, the president can dissolve the parliament by issuing a dissolution proclamation. And this is usually done upon advice of the cabinet or based on certain constitutional provisions. So I want us to think around those edges. Without even getting out of that circle, let us just circle ourselves around those edges of this circle and think about that. Ndio tusiongee stories za jaba, ndio tusipopotezane, tutumie Flora, before Flora go, I want to welcome Wanyama, my host.